Let me welcome everyone in. Now, if you're ready to begin, me too. It's time to learn about what's new in EDU.
G'day everyone, welcome to another edition of What's New in EDU. If you want to learn all about new updates and features from Microsoft Education, then you're in the right spot. Today we have the latest news from Microsoft 365 Education, Skype-a-Thon happening this month, and the new Microsoft Translator tool launch. But first, Minecraft and the Hour of Code. Take it away, Deirdre.
This has been one of the most fun and rewarding projects that I've ever worked on. Over the past 2 years, Minecraft and Code.org have worked together to introduce students and educators to coding in a Minecraft world. We've had over 66 million people play the Minecraft Hour of Code tutorials. This year, we're adding Redstone, Pistons, and the Agent from Minecraft Education Edition to introduce even more computer science concepts, like functions and debugging, in a really fun and creative way. For the first time this year, students will be able to continue their coding in Minecraft with Code Builder, breaking out of that 10x10 puzzle board into the full open world of Minecraft. Join us at code.org/Minecraft to be one of the first to try it out, and register your class to participate during Computer Science Education Week starting on December 4th.
We're excited to announce another big step in giving educators and students the full power of Microsoft technology in the classroom. Microsoft 365 Education, available now, brings together the software you know and love, like Office 365, Windows 10 and Minecraft Education Edition, along with our industry-leading security features into a single solution. Now, let's go and see what Tanvi from the Microsoft Translator team is up to.
Hi, educators. You manage many types of learners. Deaf, hard of hearing, or language learners who may not speak or understand the same language being spoken in the classroom. What if you could talk to anyone, regardless of the language they spoke? With this amazing new technology on Microsoft Translator, we're starting to bridge the communication gap. Whether you're giving a presentation in PowerPoint, like Will did for Chinese students we had on campus, or having a small group discussion, this product translates a dozen languages in speech and over 60 languages in text in real time. So here's an example. Say I'm the teacher and I have a parent who doesn't speak the same language as me. Actually, let me show you. Cue in the parent.
Wir sind gerade aus Deutschland hierher gezogen und meine Tochter Sophia wird in ihrer Klasse sein.
We just moved here from Germany and my daughter Sophia will be in this class.
That's wonderful. I'm looking forward to teaching Sophia this year.
Das ist wunderbar.
And that's it. As easy as that. With Microsoft Translator Live, you now have a personal universal translator in your pocket. So if his daughter has a hard time following along while I'm teaching, she can log on to her device and just follow along to my class. We've actually written up a few helpful documents to help you pilot this in your school or college today. So go to aka.ms/edutranslator to get these materials.
Thanks, Tanvi. Now events. The Skype-a-thon is back. It's a global event to celebrate learning without borders. November 28th to 29th, you can join thousands of educators around the world. If you're wondering where to begin, take a look at our start guide. And that's it. Thanks for joining us this month on What's New in EDU. Check out our blog for more details and links to everything you've heard here today. And don't keep all of this stuff to yourself. Share this episode with your fellow educators and administrators. I'll let the students wrap it up for us. If you want your students to help us with our next What's New in EDU, follow the link in the description below.